In the last video, you learned how the International Crane Foundation produces crane chicks from fertile eggs. In this video, you'll learn how ICF raises crane chicks. Whooping crane chicks at ICF are being raised for release into the wild. During development, crane chicks go through an imprinting process when they fix or learn to associate with a moving object in their early environment. Ideally, adult whooping cranes would raise all of our whooping crane chicks, but there are not enough adults in captivity to provide us with this opportunity. Instead, ICF has developed innovative techniques for raising captive chicks to ensure that they will associate with their own species once they are released into the wild. This video will help you understand the complex process of how cranes are raised in captivity.
After a chick is hatched in the incubation area, then they are moved out to the chick rearing facility. The Felburn Leidy chick rearing facility is a new facility that we have that is on the eastern side of our property. It's away from a lot of the activity, and that's where the chicks, especially for the birds being released, that's where all the activities raising the crane chicks occur. So we have indoor areas for the chicks so that they can stay warm and dry and food is accessible to them. And then there are outside areas, what we call chick yards, and that's where we usually exercise the birds. Imprinting, as it's classically used, is that an animal will imprint or will think it is whatever it first sees and interacts with. At the chick rearing facility, we are raising cranes basically for release. And so in this process, we want to make sure that the bird knows that it's a bird, that it's a crane. We do know that when we hand raise chicks, crane chicks, that they can and usually do imprint on us because they spend so much time with us. And as they get older, then they'll look towards human beings as mates. And we don't want that to happen because we want these birds to grow up knowing that they're a crane and that they will be released in the wild and they'll hopefully look for another crane to mate with, and then we can have a self-sustaining population in the wild. We wear the costume so that we are covered from head to toe. The costume has an area where we can look through and we can see the chicks. Actually, they have better eyesight than we do, so we have to be very careful when we're wearing the costume. And then instead of us being just a person feeding them with a spoon, then we'll use this puppet. And with the puppet, then we can pick up food and we can feed the chick as if it's taking food from its parents. In general, we try to have auditory noises from people limited. We actually have tape-recorded contact calls, and so under our costume in a pocket, we have that playing. We also have what we call brood models, and they can either be a decoy, or it could be a stuffed crane or a swan, so made into looking like a whooping crane. There's a couple other things that we have out in the chick yards. We have ponds. In those ponds, we will either put a decoy that is painted like a whooping crane in the water to encourage the birds to come to the water. Sometimes we hang it from the flight netting there so that the chicks won't run into it. And then also, probably the most important thing is that we have an adult. We call it a role model, but we have an adult across the fence line so that the adult can't hurt the chick. The adult does the alarm calls if there's something like a deer walking by, so that the chick hears not only a recorded sound that we play, but also the real thing playing and responding to the natural environment. There are things that we do just on a regular basis when a chick first hatches. They get a physical exam. We use a gray costume, not a white costume, and we do that because we don't want them associating bad things with white costumes, which is eventually what's going to be their parent. Crane chicks can grow very quickly. They can gain a lot of weight, and as they're growing and they get spindly legs, that's probably the biggest place that we have issues, is that they grow too fast, they're not getting enough exercise, and then we have some problems with either crooked toes or mostly with rotations of legs. So if we see that, we end up having to either put special tape on their legs, or there are times that we end up putting them on swim therapy, hydrotherapy, and they go swimming in a warmed swimming pool for, if they can, up to 15 minutes, 20 minutes. And then depending upon how severe those rotations are, we might do it two or three times a day. Basically, it's just a progression from, all based on how the chick is doing, from the staying in the brooder box, and if they're up and going and the weather is nice, then the costume with the puppet comes in, being a parent, and leads them out into outside areas to get exercised, fresh air, try to forage a little bit, improve their coordination, and we just continue doing that and lengthen the time that the costume is with the chick.
Whooping crane chicks stay at the Felburn Lighty Chick Rearing Facility for 3 to 7 weeks. At the end of June or early July, the crane chicks are placed in crates specially designed for their transport and are moved to Nisida National Wildlife Refuge in Nisida, Wisconsin. In the next video, you will learn how cranes raised in captivity are released into the wild.